Can you talk a little bit about how you got started as a creature performer in particular?
It's a long story, and I'll try and cut it short. I was doing a show in London called Barnum at the London Palladium, and they were advertising the trades for actors to portray apes. And so a bunch of us went along to audition, and we didn't really know what it was. And till the fourth audition, when the director was there, and he said, "This is a Tarzan movie, and these apes have to be believable." So that was my first introduction to wearing an ape suit. And it was the ape suits were designed and made by Rick Baker. He just got his first Oscar from American Werewolf in London. And so after that, I went on to do Gorillas in the Mist, and that was my start really into wearing costumes that I wasn't seen in.
How important do you think it is that our creative industries preserve these practical techniques that have given us so much movie magic for generations?
Well, I think if you look back at the older movies, Return to Oz and Little Shop of Horrors and things like that, they stand the test of time. And a lot of the computer stuff, you know, after a few years, especially if you're watching on TV, it looks like a computer game. But, you know, I guess that's the way things are going. I wish all the fans that come all the best, and some of them do incredible stuff. I did a Comic Con in the States last year, and there was a guy had made from Hellboy 2 the Johann Krauss outfit, the whole thing, and it was perfect. I mean, the color wise, everything. So, you know, some of these fans just go to a heck of a lot of trouble and do some great work. Thank goodness for the fans.